Hello everyone, welcome back to Mass Effect 3! Here we are on the... We're on Mars, we're at the Prothean Archives. Look, you can look out the window and everything. Look at that, it's totally Mars. Oh! From Amelia Hatterson to Mike O'Sullivan. Hey, stupid head! I won't ask how you're doing since I hear you guys are propagating germs in the shape of a cult down there in storage. Look, I know your Prothean doodads are fascinating and all, but you guys have got to stop burning the midnight oil and keep regular sleeping hours, honestly! Anyway, I forwarded you the latest findings to HQ on Earth, and someone is depressurizing the area! One secure! Oh my god! Oh, poor Amelia Hatterson! She seemed really cool! Oh man, I feel bad that she's dead, because she sounds kind of awesome. I will avenge you, Amelia Hatterson. I like how he's continuing his conversation. He's like, oh shit, Commander Shepard, still. We need to finish talking. This is an important conversation, it cannot wait. It's like, oh right, okay, so here we have the shieldy guys, also known as Guardians. Now, we have a neat trick we can do against Guardians that's super duper fun, which is pulling their shields off them with pull. Damn it, it missed. Yeah, let's just switch over to a cooler gun. Yeah, so these guys have shields. You actually get an achievement the first time you manage to shoot through the hole in their shield. It's very, very satisfying. But we're just gonna yank the shields off them. Yoink! Yeah, not so tough now, are you? Yoink! This always makes you really popular if you're playing Adept in multiplayer. It's like, yeah. That and Singularity. Singularity will always make your Adept a popular person. Okay, so here we have Pfizer Heikel Tkele. I can't pronounce that, I'm really sorry. To Sandoval Fletcher. Yeah, I know, two external specialists in the same week is a bit insane, but Hudson, I've heard about the Asari before. She's really well known and she's done some amazing research on the Protheans. I don't know zip about that Dr. Eva chick, but Liara Tassoni? She's the real thing. I've been attaching some of her advanced papers on Prothean culture. Read them. You'll be a believer too when you're done. I can't believe it. I can't wait until they introduce her to people. This is so exciting, Pfizer. Oh, hey, they're saying nice things about you, Liara. That's really nice of them. Aww. Oh, that shield just vanished. Yeah, you can't just pick up enemy weapons in this, you have to find, like... Well, those guys are super dead. Whoa, you're not super dead. You're definitely not dead. Hey. Yeah, piss off. Oh shit. There's a lot of them. So we're just gonna retire to a safe distance. Oh, who's shooting me? There was nobody with line of sight! Oh no, come on! Oh. Is it impossible to get that whole conversation? We are to do the honors. Boom. Here come the Guardians. They're too far away. Oh, stop switching me over to this gun. I want my shooter duper. Yeah. Yeah, that was a letterbox shot, I think, on that guy, but it's easier than getting this shield. So, this is one of the first instances we'll see of special troops. Stop doing that! Yeah, so special troops are kind of... Yeah, we read that one, right? I just want to make sure we get the XP for these readings. I don't know if it, like, resets those. So there are, like, special trooper types that you can... There we go. you can meet in this, and each type of enemy has like several special troops. Right, I'm not falling for that mistake again. Alright, that's singularity. Yes, walk backwards into- aww. Oh, are these guys still go- oh shit. So here we have the Centurion, which, as you'd guess from the name, they're like leader guys. They have shields, so they're a bit tougher. Ash, why don't you do some shooty shooting? Ash, more shooting, please. The thing about like soldier characters is that anything that they do, like special abilities wise, is a bit less obvious than a character like Liara, because Liara, you can see that she's using singularity because it's like, oh yeah, like they're all floating about and there's a big singularity in the room. Like, whereas with Ash, it's like, is she shooting more? Is she effective at all? Where is she? Ash? Ash, no wonder you were doing fuck all. You were in the other room, just chilling, like, hey, I'm Ash, I'm gonna stand in here and be a space racist, yeah. Hey, Commander, I'm not gonna help you at all. I'm just gonna go over here. I'm American, I'll do whatever I want. Come on. Shit! That was not what I wanted! Oh no! They are literally right in front of me! Okay, that was pretty funny, really. One day we'll look back on this and laugh. Oh, I'll look back on this and laugh. Cause you're dead. Okay, let's go. Liara, give him a lift. Or a singularity, but it's pretty much the same sort of thing as lift. Right. I'm quite glad that lift in this is kind of replaced with hold, which is a more useful ability. Let's chuck some grenades in there. We've got loads of Okay, you shepherd can't throw for shit. So that's a thing we've discovered today. Oh, run away! They can't beat droid cars. Thanks, Ash, for actually doing something. Wow. Oh cool, look at that lab with all the bits of rock in it and stuff. They're all being like doing research and things. I feel bad that the scientists are probably all dead.
What's that smell? They just activated the decontamination protocols. With the staff still inside.
Oh no. Oh no, Cerberus, why do you do this? Oh, Cerberus. Okay, so this is, kind of a fun little thing.
This is where they studied the various relics unearthed here.
Aww.
What did they find?
More than I could describe in a short conversation.
Okay. Personal notes, Dr. S. Esparza. Esparza? Esparza? I don't know. Dr. S. somebody. We haven't been able to decipher much, if any, of the language yet, but the visual documentation gives us some idea as to what they were studying, namely us. They seemed particularly interested in early humanity's evolutionary process, judging by the way they organised their files and highlighted specific occasions. It seems a bit fantastic to write this, but everything indicates that they seem to be trying to chart the curve of humanity's intellectual progression.
There are vaults filled with Prothean data troves that have never been studied.
Huh. Okay, so if you get the things just right. There are extra items you can grab in here, like that one over there. That is what we want. Also, we need to get through here. So we go back and we press the buttons again. Get out here, guys. Come on. Come on.
As you wish.
No, not you.
Understood.
All right. So you gals chill over there. Okay. Can I open... let's see. Yeah. No! Damn it. Okay. If they're right over the door, you can't actually... there's another one over here where you can kind of see what you're doing a bit better. Okay, that's what we need. So now we have this wider area. We can grab the extended barrel for the sniper rifle, which is very nice, and continue on our merry way. We won't find another...
That's the tramline. Takes us right to the archives.
Nice.
No doubt Cerberus has it locked down. Hopefully we can override it at the security station. It's just through here.
Nothing over here. As I'm wandering through this corridor, you get a nice look at how Mass Effect 3, just the graphics are all just a little bit nicer, just a little bit more polished. The textures are a bit higher resolution. Ooh, a shotgun. Let's have a look. I don't think anybody's really needing a shotgun, but the katana is a solid choice. These like basic first weapons that you pick up, the nice thing about them tends to be that they're quite reliable, relatively low weight, etc. Oh shit.
Look out! No kidding! Is that the only way in? It's the only way I know of. We'll skirt around it. Stay out of its sights. I'll move up first.
Okay, so this is basically the tutorial for Mass Effect 3's new cover
Don't
mechanics.
Let it target you!
Which are kind of cool. So you can do this, and you can spacebar to sprint.
Get me out of here!
So we do this.
Get me out of here!
Yeah, we're getting you out of there, Ash. Okay, so let's just edge over.
Keep your head down!
Oof. Ow, fuck!
Damn it!
Okay, so, so that's what I was supposed to do.
Damn it. Clear. The turret can't fire on us from here.
Haha. Hey guys. What is up? What are the haps? You can see like the reflections on Shepard's outfit, and like how it uses like lots of nice textures and things, and variation of like specularity levels. So you get this kind of really nice tactile look to the game because of that. Can't stop us. Okay. This is, I can't remember what's down there. Is there anything? We'll shut off the security before we do anything. So that we can go and have a look. Datapad. Research notes. Tasman. The last location seems to have run dry, but judging from the communication system layout and backup power supplies equipped by the first Prothean base we discovered, we think a secondary base may be located deeper underground. We're going to need permission from the powers that be to excavate further, but considering the recent renewal in enthusiasm for the work we're doing here, I don't think clearance will be an issue. A hidden Prothean base, eh? Sniper rifle concentration module. Not sure if I've ever used one of those. It never seemed super useful to me. Let's see what else we got in here. Let's check this, I guess.
Set up a perimeter. No one else comes across.
We still have teams on the other side.
No one! And shut down those cameras.
That's a really familiar
Looks like they've
voice.
Made it to the archives.
And it looks like they won't be sitting a tram anytime soon. Can you override it?
The archives are on a separate network. We're completely locked out.
Not completely. What if we could find a short-range transmitter? Helmet to helmet.
And?
And then we convince them that we're with them. And the Alliance forces have been taken care of.
Good idea. See what you can find. What?
The Lieutenant Commander has become very capable.
Agreed.
Commander, I found something.
Are you ready for more Cerberus acting like supervillains? Cause oh boy.
He's got a transmitter in his helmet. If I can... Oh!
Dun dun dun!
Oh god. He looks like a husk.
Yeah, not quite. They've definitely done something to him.
Engineered? By Cerberus? They claim to stand for humanity, and they do this to their own people. That could have been you, Shepard. For all I knew, that's what Cerberus had done to you.
I'm sorry. Do you see any glowing... eyes right here? Because, well, admittedly, if I was a renegade right now,
how can you compare
she might
me
have
that?
A point, because I would have like,
I don't know what
glowing
you are.
Lines on my face
Not
and
since
crap.
They got their hands on you. Is it really you? Would you even know if they were controlling you somehow?
You know, she does
That's
have a point.
That's not fair, Ash.
I'm just talking out loud. I don't need you to answer. I doubt there's anything you could say to convince me. I guess I just need some time to get to know you again.
She does have a point, really, though, because, like, if we had been changed by Cerberus, how would we know?
I'm the same person I always was. Time won't change that.
That said, our actions to this point would suggest that we haven't.
Thanks for understanding.
You bet.
Unless Cerberus had some kind of crazy Xanatos gambit going on, where they were like, aha, we will.
Hello, this is Delta Team. Anybody there?
Where the hell are you, man? Never mind, what's your status?
We're at the tram station, waiting for extraction. All hostiles terminated.
Roger that. Echo Team will ride over and secure the station.
Hey, I didn't know we had somebody
they
who sounded like
it.
Jennifer Hale
they
on our team.
Figure it out soon enough. We should get in position. Flank them when they get off the tram.
Good thinking, Elsie.
Okay, why can't I move? Oh, it won't let me move until I do the thing with the Q and the E.
Right away!
Is there anything I can nick up here? I like shiny things to steal. Shiny things appeal to me greatly. Dinner. Well, how did they know they were there? They haven't moved yet. They're just standing behind some boxes completely. Maybe they have mini-maps as well. Yeah, that would make sense. In space, everyone has mini-maps. I wish I had a mini-map in real life. That would be, like, the reason I'd get a Google Glass, honestly, would just be to have a mini-map in real life, like in a video game. I think I have talked before about how I am really, really bad at navigation. It's kind of a running joke among a lot of my friends is that I have terrible sense of direction, actually. Really pretty bad. Oh man, Ash is laying into him. Oh, combat feels so satisfying in Mass Effect 3. It's hard to describe without you playing it for yourself, but it's really like smooth and responsive and fast, and it just feels right. Like, you just play it and you go, yeah, that's how it should handle. That's how I want the game to feel when I play it. Something about this music sounds, it like makes me think of FF10. You know Final Fantasy X, like, there's that, like, Sin music that comes on, and it's got that same kind of metallic kind of drum-type sound to it. Oh, for goodness sake, stop camping in the corner there! Alright. Hey, Ash. Haha, hop over those boxes into that corner. There's nobody there, Ash. Okay, so here we have some trams. We're gonna go for a nice tram ride. It's gonna be fun. Those shields vanishing, it's just kind of funny. But okay.
Storm's getting bad. We better wrap this up quickly.
The archives are right on the other side.
That and a squad of pissed off Cerberus
troops. Uh-oh. Oh, did we level up? I like level ups. Haha. Oh no, the singularity doesn't move with the tram. They could have sniped us from afar, but instead they're gonna come over here, because, you know, why not? That seems safe. Oh, I'm sure that cyborg lady we engineered isn't dangerous. We can take her. She's only, like, the best soldier the human race has ever produced, and also a genetic, like, a super, like, cyborg and shit. Like, who wants, like, beat up a Reaper aided only by random genetically engineered lady and Aquarian?
They put up a good fight. Yes, it confirms my assertions about the value of the data stored here.
Man, Liara kind of talking like Kanaya there. Needlessly convoluted way of saying it. Do we really need to stand at the control pad like this the whole time? All the way there? Oh yeah. Uh-oh. Is that... That's a grenade. That's definitely a grenade. Yep. Make lemonade, not grenades. Oh my. The, physics continues to cause shenanigans in Mass Effect 3, but less so than Mass Effect 2. Like, I think the level design is slightly more solid, so they're less designed so that people fly off and into inaccessible areas. One of the things about Mass Effect 3 is that it's kind of designed for multiplayer, actually. It's one of the few games where having a multiplayer option has actually improved the game as a whole, because the enemy types have to be diverse, and it has to be designed to be really solid so that it's not going to have too many exploitable loopholes, and each quest has something interesting to do. Ooh, I have a text from my mum. That's nice. It's always nice to have a text from my mum. So, one of the things that I don't know if I actually mentioned while doing my Mass Effect Let's Play is that if you follow me on Twitter, you probably know about it. About 6 months ago, my sister had a baby, so I am now Auntie Kate to a little baby called Hazel, who is so cute. Oh, she's super cute, and she's ginger like me, kind of. She doesn't have a lot of hair yet. Very little hair. She's, you know, like, she's waiting on the hair. But yeah, as is often the duty of grandparents, my mum babysits her niece a lot. Come on, Cerberus. One of the things about the faster combat and different enemy types is that it makes the waves of enemies a bit less tiresome than they were in Mass Effect 2. So you like the pacing of them and the variation of types and things just feels a bit less like than it had a tendency to in the previous game. Ooh, shinies. Shotgun Shredder mod. I don't like these mods, like I don't tend to use them, the ones that now this is a good gun, the Vindicator. So we now have the Avenger, or we can have the Vindicator, which I'm gonna switch her out to. Do I have any mods for that? No. And the sniper rifle. I can't weapon mods because for some reason you can only do weapon mods at a modification bench. You can't just do them while you're doing, what is it, thingy do for the loadout. So if you're doing loadout, you can't change your mods. You can only change them when you're at a weapon bench, which is annoying because you never, almost never find weapon benches in the middle of levels in this. They are pretty much always at the end. Whoa, this is cool.
Ash.
Prothean Obelisk. You may remember the Prothean Obelisk from Mass Effect 1, which gave Shepard the vision of the coming of the Reapers. It's Tim!
Shepard.
Liara, it's a hologram.
Elusive man.
Liara, it's a fucking hologram.
The Protheans. They left all this for us to discover, but we squandered it. The Alliance has known about the archives for more than 30 years. And what have they done with it?
What do you want?
Oh no, I forgot to put Skype on Do Not Disturb, sorry.
The data in these artifacts holds the key to solving the Reaper threat.
I've seen your solution. Your people are turned into monsters.
Hardly. They're being improved.
Improved?
That's what separates us, Shepard. Where you see a means to destroy, I see a way to control, to dominate and harness the Reaper's power. Imagine how strong humanity would be if we controlled them.
What?
Earth is under siege and you're hatching a scheme to control the Reapers?
You've always been short-sighted, hasty. Your destruction of the Collector base proved that.
That base was an abomination. Hundreds of thousands of humans were murdered there.
This isn't your fight any longer, Shepard. You can't defeat the Reapers. Even with the Prothean data.
So this is an interesting thing. If you don't ask him the extra questions and do all these interrupts, there's a thing that can happen later, and I actually missed it because I missed a couple of opportunities to ask him more questions and get these Paragon options when I first played. So this is going to be something interesting. I'm going to try to get all of these persuade options for them.
Work with me. Give me control of your resources and I'll stop them.
You'd do better than most, but the odds aren't in your favor. More importantly, I don't want the Reapers destroyed. We can dominate them, use their power, harness their very essence to bring humanity to the apex of evolution.
You know what's surprising about the Elusive Man? He has, like, robo eyes and stuff, but that appears to be an actual cigarette. It's not like he's vaping.
You've gone too far. The Reapers will kill us all if we don't stop fighting each other.
I don't expect you to understand, Shepard, and I'm certainly not looking for your approval. You were a tool, an agent with a singular purpose, and despite our differences, you were relatively successful.
Oh god, it's this guy.
But like the rest of the relics in this place, your time is over.
Enough talk. Liara?
Don't interfere with my plan, Shepard. I won't warn you again.
Duly noted.
Shepard!
What?
The data, it's not here. It's being erased.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Damn it! How's he doing it?
It's local. Someone's uploading the information.
Hey! Step away from the console. Now!
Oh, shit. You have to be a pretty badass person at martial arts to get the drop on Ash. So, yeah.
Ah,
shit. Let's run. Go, go, go!
We can't lose her!
Okay, Liara, I appreciate the attempt with singularity there. Right. So this is... what? Oh, it's like we just...
There she is!
Right, so
Stay
this is a chase sequence. She's not getting away, I can see her.
Watch out!
So this kind of really shows off the speed of Mass Effect 3 compared to previous games in the series. Like, you get this fluidity to it, and...
James, you read me? Cerberus has the data!
Ow! Back here.
Radio the Normandy! Get them down here now!
Ah. No. Fuck. No. Shepard, move! Go! No, come here. No! Go up the fucking ladder! Go up the ladder!
She's getting away! Damn it! James! Normandy! Anybody!
Doofus to the rescue! Well, that was a violent solution to that problem.
Normandy's en route. They'll be here soon.
We need the data.
Whoa, shit. She's a robot. Oh, shit.
Ash!
Let her go.
Orders?
Finish her.
Uh-oh. No!
No!
Damn it, no, we worked hard to... We worked hard to save Ash.
Grab that thing. Bring it with us.
Shepard, we got Reaper signatures in orbit.
Well, damn. Well, bye, Mars. Here we are on the med bay of the Normandy.
Ashley needs medical attention. We have to leave the Sol system.
I know.
The Citadel is our best chance. We can find help there.
Get us to the Citadel, Joker.
Roger that.
Hold on, Ash. See what you and Edie can learn from that thing.
Commander, I'm receiving a signal over the secondary QEC. I believe it's Admiral Hackett.
Patch me through.
I'll forward it to the comm room.
Shepard, are you reading me? Commander.
Edie, can you clear this up?
So we have a new part of the Normandy here, which...
Did you get to the archives?
I was there. So was the elusive man.
I was worried Cerberus might try something. Did you get the data?
Most of it. He downloaded some before I could stop him. Edie and Liara are analyzing what we recovered.
What have you learned? Was it worth the effort?
Preliminary evidence suggests the data is a blueprint for a Prothean device.
Device?
A weapon, massive in size and scope, that's capable of unquantifiable levels of destruction.
Send me the data. We'll do our own analysis. If Liara's instincts are right, this might be the key to stopping the Reapers.
I hope so. Lieutenant Commander Williams was critically wounded. We're taking her to the Citadel.
Sorry to hear that, Shepard. But we both know this is just the beginning. Talk to the Council, show them what you found. With luck, they'll give you all the support we need.
And if they don't?
Do whatever it takes to get them on board. I'll be in touch soon. Hack it out.
All right, so this is,
Shepard? Edie is extracting data from the Cerberus machine. We'll have details to present to the Council by the time we reach the Citadel.
And Lieutenant Commander Williams?
I've done what I can for her. She needs proper medical attention soon. The Admiral's right. It's going to get worse, isn't it?
Unless we stop the Reapers, yeah.
Oh, train going past. Wonder if that'll come
I've
out on
the
recording.
Data. This weapon could be the answer, if we can build it. I get the sense you don't quite believe it, though.
Yeah, well, I mean, putting all our faith in this one device that sounds like it could be a weapon, but it needs to defeat, like, tons and tons of Reapers is a bit... yeah.
You didn't see what they did to Earth. How is one weapon supposed to stop them?
What are our options? You know we can't win this conventionally. Shepard. Isn't it worth trying, at least?
I'm gonna check on Ashley and James. Make sure we're ready to present our findings to the Council.
I'm sure the Council will see the need to help.
It'll be a hell of a short war if they don't.
Ooh, nice little cutscene as we approach. That is a really cool shot of the Citadel. Kind of get a sense of just how big the Citadel is from a shot like that. Like, you can see the individual buildings on the kind of fin-like parts.
Barely got a pulse here.
Move him out.
Where are you taking her?
Where to Memorial? Best care in the Citadel.
We're not going with?
We need to see the Council.
Right. Looks like they might be coming to see you.
Commander Shepard.
Hey!
Got word you were arriving.
Captain Bailey, good to see you again.
Yeah, you too. Though it's Commander now.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Now half my job is dealing with political bullshit and escorting dignitaries around. No offense.
None taken. So you're here to bring us to the Council?
I'm here to tell you the Council is expecting you, but they are dealing with their own problems with the war and everything. They apologize for the inconvenience and blah, 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 blah. Meet them here at Adina's office. They'll be ready soon enough.
All right.
You might have time to go by the medical center if you want to check on progress over there.
Yeah, that does sound like a good idea.
Thanks. I might do that.
You go on ahead. I'll head up to Adina's office.
One of my men can show you the way.
You? I'm just a tourist today. I'll try not to get in any trouble.
Commander, we've got a situation in the embassy quarters. We could use your help.
I'll be right there. The other half of my job. I'll see you around, Shepard.
No doubt.
So now we get to run around on the Citadel a bit. One of the things about Mass Effect 3 is that it's always really dark everywhere. Like, the lighting is always sort of dark and also quite harsh. Oh, hey, it's Avena.
Well, they said that due to concerns about signal congestion, we're supposed to avoid sending messages at all. They're trying to keep war data coming through, so every data packet counts.
So how am I supposed to talk with you then?
So, one of the other things about Mass Effect 3 is that when you go to an area, you'll get bits of conversations that
Hello,
are ongoing.
Hello, Commander Shepard. Welcome to the Citadel. This is Docking Bay D-24. Note that due to recent events, official identification and weapons permits may be requested by CSEC personnel for routine verification.
Okay.
What's with the heightened security?
New screening fields have been added in order to speed up processing at the security stations in each docking area. Citadel security screening technology uses highly advanced biometric authentication systems developed by the Serta Foundation. Please note that any attempt to circumvent Citadel security measures will result in immediate incarceration.
Okay.
That's all.
Good to know.
Please speak with me again if you require further assistance.
Handy. Okay. We've got a keeper wandering around. Keepers look great with that up.
You have to.
Oh. So, this is a
What's
new
going
face.
On here?
And a weird looking
Commander,
face.
Just who I was looking for. Diana Allers, Alliance News Network. I think we can help each other.
I suppose you want an interview?
Even better.
What's with all the trains today?
I'm a military reporter with a show called Battle Space. We're carried on just about all Council planets. My producers want me embedded on a human ship, and I want that ship to be the Normandy.
Why would I want that?
Wars can be won or lost in the editing room, and this war needs to be won. I've got Alliance security clearance and operate without a crew. You get veto power over the segments I file. Can you handle an arrangement like that? Or do I keep looking?
So the reason this lady has such a weird face is that she was modeled on an actual presenter lady. Like, she was on some kind of a gaming show or something. I never watched it. Or she was like a spokeslady for Xbox. Something like that. And they actually put her in the game. So she does the voice and it's her face. I can't even remember what her name was. But yeah, that's why she doesn't quite have the same stylized look to her face as all the other characters, and it looks a little bit weird.
Tell your producers yes for now. We'll see how it works out. Report to the ship as soon as possible. Any questions?
How much gear can I bring?
One footlocker.
Aye aye, Commander.
Okay, so we've picked up Diana Alice. And is there anyone else to talk to in here? No? Okay, cool. So we'll go through the security. You can normally pop back over to the Normandy with that fast transport. And let's head on over to Huerta Memorial Hospital. So I think this is... I'm pretty sure that voiceover for all the lifts and stuff is Ali Hillis, who voices Liara, which is a really weird thing if that is the case, because it's the same as that bit in the opening where Jennifer Hale was there. It's like, why? Why cast one of your major voice actresses as another, like, voice you're going to hear a lot? But anyway, this is where we're going to end this episode. Next time we're going to go and see Ash and go and see Udina, and it'll probably be one of those talky episodes where we don't actually do any fighting and do a lot of running around chatting to people, getting to know the Normandy and the crew and everything. So join us then for that.